In the holy name of Jesus and Mother Mary, Sisters of Saint Anne of Luzon, Bangalore Province, welcome you to the presentation on The Assumption of Immaculate Mother of God, Part 6, Saints' Quotes Used in the Apostolic Constitution, The Most Bountiful God, by Pope Pius XII in support of the dogma. Saint John Damascene. In the homily he delivered at the Basilica of the Domitian in Jerusalem, pointed to Mary's tomb and said, Her immaculate body was placed here in this renowned and all-glorious tomb, from whence after 3 days it was taken up to the heavenly mansion. The Most Bountiful God, paragraph 21. Saint Amadeus. The Virgin Mary's flesh had remained incorrupt, for it is wrong to believe that her body has seen corruption, because it was really united again to her soul and together with it crowned with great glory in the heavenly courts. For she was full of grace and blessed among women. She alone merited to conceive the true God of true God, whom as a virgin she brought forth, to whom as a virgin she gave milk, fondling him in her lap, and in all things she waited upon him with loving care. The Most Bountiful God, paragraph 28. Saint Bonaventura. As God had preserved the Most Holy Virgin Mary from the violation of her virginal purity and integrity in conceiving and in childbirth, He would never have permitted her body to have been resolved into dust and ashes. MT, paragraph 32. Saint Bonaventura. The Blessed Virgin is there in heaven bodily. Her blessedness would not have been complete unless she were there as a person. The soul is not a person, but the soul joined to the body is a person. It is manifest that she is there in soul and in body. Otherwise, she would not possess her complete beatitude. The Most Bountiful God, paragraph 32. Saint Bernardine of Siena. The likeness between God's Mother and her Divine Son in the way of the nobility and dignity of body and of soul, a likeness that forbids us to think of the Heavenly Queen as being separated from the Heavenly King, makes it entirely imperative that Mary should be only where Christ is. MD 33. Saint Robert Bellarmine, an Italian Jesuit and a cardinal of the Catholic Church, exclaimed, And who, I ask, could believe that the Ark of Holiness, the dwelling place of the Word God, the temple of the Holy Spirit, could be reduced to ruin? My soul is filled with horror at the thought that this virginal flesh which had begotten God, had brought him into the world, had nourished and carried him, could have been turned into ashes or given over to be food for worms. MT 34. Saint Alphonsus Liguori. In his book, The Glories of Mary, he writes that Jesus did not wish to have the body of Mary corrupted after death, since it would have redounded to his own dishonor to have her virginal flesh, from which he himself had assumed flesh, reduced to dust. The Most Bountiful God, paragraph 35. The Catechism of the Catholic Church, number 966, quoting the Byzantine liturgy, states, The Assumption of the Blessed Virgin is a singular participation in her son's resurrection and an anticipation of the resurrection of other Christians. Mary, the Mother of God, being immaculate in her conception, a most perfect virgin in her divine motherhood, the noble associate of the divine Redeemer, has won a complete triumph over sin and its consequences. As the supreme culmination of her privileges, Mother Mary was preserved from the corruption of the tomb and taken up body and soul to the glory of heaven, where as queen she sits in splendor at the right hand of her son, the immortal king of the ages. In the gospel according to Saint Luke chapter 2 verses 18 and 51, we read, Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. Mary, who carried the incarnate word in her womb, always pondered about the heaven and the kingdom who is Jesus. Her heart, mind and soul always looked to heavenward. Mary spent heaven while she was in the earth. Seek the things that are above. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. Our life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ is revealed, then you also will be revealed with him in glory. Colossians chapter 3 verses 1 to 4. This is the sure assurance of our own resurrection, that just like Mary, we assume heaven, spend heaven, ponder heaven, and inherit heaven. May all of us who believe in the Assumption of Mother Mary and meditate upon her glorious example value our human earthly life. May we devote our life entirely in carrying out the will of our Heavenly Father as she did. May our Mother Mary keep us under the protection of her mantle during our life's journey and intercede to her Son Jesus and obtain necessary graces for us, her children.